That's a very difficult question for me to answer, considering I don't have the information at this point. I'm not an incumbent, so I didn't have any information on that. I would definitely research it. I know what it is, but I don't have an answer for that at this point.
Thank you. Ms. Diamond, what is your opinion on RFA?
I think we have to weigh the risks. Certainly, City of Canton's most valuable resource is our water. We don't want to do anything that is going to put that asset at risk. At the same time, we don't want to be dependent on foreign oil, natural gas. We have got to find a way to become independent, not just in the City of Canton, but in the United States, become independent. We have to explore. We have to do, I think, fracking at some point, but we have to be guaranteed our water supply is going to remain safe and our soil and our land. It's a delicate balance. Leaders have to come up with a formula, an idea of how we can continue the exploration of natural gas and at the same time protecting our city assets.
Thank you. Mr. Morgan, your opinion, please.
I think hydraulic fracturing, particularly when associated with horizontal drilling, is dangerous. I don't think there is any way to ensure that it will not ultimately lead to contamination of underground water supplies. I'm worried about it, and if it is to be done because of all our best efforts, we cannot stop it. I think we need to trust someone other than the oil and gas companies, i.e. regulators, who aren't oil and gas companies, to look out for our interests and to do it stringently.
Mr. Cross, your opinion on fracking?
First of all, it's very dangerous. I worked for the street department for 33 years, and I knew the other departments quite well because when I was union president, I used to visit those departments and stay in contact with them. Our water lines are deep. They're the deepest. And you have gas lines sitting on top of that. You have underground cables. Anytime you disturb the ground, not only are you going to destroy them pipes, maybe not directly with a direct rupture, you're going to disturb the ground, which causes the pipes to have danger. And most of the water pipes are very old. When I was on council, I tried to get the city to initiate a plan to start going back and looking at doing something with those pipes. So the bottom line being, it's dangerous. It's always going to be dangerous if it comes to the point where it starts to be regulated by the government and you have no choice. Then you have to look at ways to be an active along with the people that's doing that so that your local people on council and administration and your gas, water, and people who sit on those are on a committee that we can advocate some checking and double checking on those. But to anytime you get into fracking, you're looking at a problem.
Thanks. Mr. Cole, you know what your opinion too.
Certainly. Sir, I'm 110% against it, and let me tell you why. Several weeks back, we had a meeting with representatives from Pennsylvania and New York, and they discussed the issues that fracking had did to their community. Rare forms of cancer, the chemicals, fire coming up from the faucets. It is ridiculous. We cannot take that chance. And when Republicans for years have distorted the EPA, the sanctity of the EPA, then you can't count on them to come in and save us in that situation. This is a very difficult situation, but it's a no-brainer. The risks far outweigh any sort of gain we could possibly have. Our health, our water is what's going to sustain us for the next 100 years. That water supply, that is going to be how we're going to move forward within our community. And if that's damaged, we're going to have to pack it up and find another place to live, folks.
You're not to be left out with your opinion.
Thank you. I agree with Mr. Cole. I'm against anything and anybody that is going to jeopardize our greatest resource that we have in the city of Canton, and that is our water. We have to protect not only our citizens, but we have to protect our interests also.
Fracking is, I'm totally against it. Again, as it was stated earlier, you know, our most valuable resource here is our water supply. When you look at some of the southern states down and around like Georgia and South Carolina, they actually have water shortages in the summer in the hot months. And if that continues, I think that, you know, we could be sitting, or I believe that we are sitting on one of the most abundant financial resources that we have based on our position with the Great Lakes. So as far as my position, I'm against fracking, and I will continue to do what needs to be done to fight against that.
Thank you. Mr. Merrill, this question from the audience was really directed at you, and I thought, well, I would use it. What is your opinion on the fracking process?
Well, with the fracking, I think we have to think about two things, what the city owns and what the city doesn't own. And with the fracking, the city will not own the natural gas. The city owns the water. By allowing another company to come in, pay a very small amount to harness that natural gas, and the potential danger that it will cause for our water supply, what we'll be doing is we'll be trading what I heard at council, I think it was a $1.3 billion asset for a very small amount of money. So I am 100% against it. I'm also against it because my industry is in water treatment. One of the things that I see a lot is people with methane gas, the first thing you ask them is, do you have any oil wells around your house? And almost 100% of the time they say yes. It's a proven fact that when you do the drilling, it will affect the water supply. Arkansas is having a lot of problems with major or minor earthquakes, where they've had reported 1,000 minor earthquakes since they allowed the fracking to happen. So there are so many things that are negative of the fracking, and to ruin our water supply, it just isn't worth it.